So sharing files and sharing bibliographic information with students or with colleagues is incredibly easy to do with Mendeley, in particular because the software allows for it. Additionally, we also have everything stored in Dropbox. The two particular ways I do it is either I'll do it through email or I'll share a file through Dropbox. So let me show you exactly what we can do. Let's say we have these three particular files that we have a colleague or a student that's interested in and they want to read it and take a look at it. What I can do is highlight any of them. So for this example, I'll just highlight these three. I'll go up to File and I'll say Send by Email. So it'll bring up this prompt box with all three PDFs in it, and I can send it to whoever I want. So I'll send it to johnsmith@gmail.com. Happy reading. And then I'll just click send, I'll send it to one person, and then it'll be able to go through and they'll be able to access all three PDFs and to be able to read them, and we can communicate that way. Now the second way we can do it is through Dropbox. So because we have the desktop software of Dropbox, I can simply open this up, or you could do it online through the cloud service of Dropbox, and I can highlight and copy whatever I'm interested in sending to whoever wants to read it, and I can click share. So if I click share, I can email and I can say happy reading. And I could share this with them as well. So that way they'll have access to the Dropbox file and they'll be able to view it. Now let's suppose I'm working on a paper with a colleague and maybe I'm second or third author and I was asked to write a section of the paper and I used some references within the section that I wrote. After I send them what I have from the paper, I'll generally include with that an RIS file or a BibTeX file if they're interested in using that platform in order to give them the bibliographic metadata that they can include in whatever software they may be using, or they can just simply include within the paper that they're working on. So let me show you exactly how to do this. Let's say that I wrote part of a paper and I want to include these three articles and I put them in as references and I want to share the bibliographic data. So that way my co-author can simply just upload them to their system or just put them directly into paper. So I highlighted all three, and what I'll do is I'll go up to File and I'll go to Export. Now this allows us the opportunity to choose the type of file. So we can either use a BibTeX file if they're using that type of platform, or maybe they're using EndNote, they might not be using Mendeley. We can download it into an EndNote file, or more generally and broadly, we can use an RIS file, the same type of file that we use to gather bibliographic data from databases in earlier tutorials. So I'll click on that and I will name it Brian's References for Paper 1, and I'll save that onto the desktop, and then I can take this file and attach it into an email and send it to my colleagues. Similarly, if maybe I'm the first author and I'm assembling an entire paper and I'm working with multiple people, generally I'll ask them to send all of the related references in an RIS form. That way they'll send me this particular file and all I have to do is just drag it into my Mendeley, and then it'll give me all the particular sources that I need. Sometimes I don't necessarily need the actual PDFs, I might just need the bibliographies. So what I can do then is just create a new folder, I can call it Paper 1. And I can take all of this information and just drag it into Paper 1 from all of my multiple co-authors, and then that way I'm very organized in terms of the references. Once that happens, I can then put them into the paper and generate it through some of the processes that I'll show you in later tutorials. I hope you enjoyed the video and found it helpful. If you did, make sure to give us a big thumbs up and like the video. If you haven't done so already, be sure to subscribe to our channel by clicking the link above, and make sure to check out some of our other videos. We'll see you again soon.